What's up, everybody? This is my UFC 112 review. As for the night, you know, it had some great moments and it had some terrible moments. I'll get to that, though. I won the pick'ems, so that's cool, I guess. That was pretty cool. But other than that, you know, this show was not worth the money I paid, you know. I'll get to it. Anyways, first fight of the night, Kendall Grove versus Mark Munoz. This was a great fight. I love this fight. Grove took it to Munoz early. Showed, you know, he was getting him with the knees and had some tight chokes in that I thought was going to finish the fight. But Munoz showed, you know, a lot of heart and refused to quit and kept battling and ended up getting on top of him. Used his superior wrestling and just ground and pound. That's that man's bread and butter. He's very good at ground and pound. And he just wore him out and stopped him. Great win for Mark Munoz. The sky's the limit for this guy, you know. You show that much heart and you show, you know, you're a great wrestler and can throw bombs like that on the ground, you know, this guy can be something. So look out for Mark Munoz. You know, he works out with a lot of tough guys too, so look out for Munoz. But great fight. Great way to start off the show. Wish every fight was like this. But anyways, up next was Terry Adam versus Rafael Dos Anjos. This fight was fair. It was okay. Terry Adam had the clear advantage standing up, but once it got to the ground, Rafael Dos Anjos had the clear advantage on the ground. You know, his jiu-jitsu was far too much for Adam to put up with, and it looked like Dos Anjos was going for a Kimura. He switched it over to an armbar. It was beautiful. He got the armbar, and Adam was forced to tap, and it was a good win for Rafael Dos Anjos over a tough opponent, you know. Elevates him even more, so he showed great jiu-jitsu, and that was a pretty good fight. But up next was Matt Hughes versus Renzo Gracie, and this fight was garbage, man. You know, I was looking for this fight to hit the ground. You know, I thought Matt Hughes would use his wrestling and just pound on him, but Renzo's boxing was so bad. You know, Matt Hughes don't have good boxing either, but I mean, Matt Hughes just outstruck him. And then finally in the third round, you know, he finally stopped him. He was killing him with the leg kicks, you know, the leg kicks added up, and Renzo just couldn't hardly stand on his leg. And that led to the end of the fight, you know. I got major respect for Renzo Gracie. The Gracies, you know, tons of respect for those guys. Matt Hughes, I'm still not sold, you know, that Matt Hughes is back or nothing. I still think he's, you know, he's over... he's way past his prime, I think. And if he faces, you know, a pretty big opponent next, you know, a guy that's in their prime, I'm pretty sure they'll shut Matt Hughes down. But we'll see who he faces next. But anyway, it was just, wasn't too good of a fight. But up next, the co-main event. All right. This was a good part of the show. BJ Penn and Frankie Edgar went at it. Now, I told you guys in my little preview, I picked Penn to win. Yes, I did. And I even said that he was unbeatable at 155. I'm wrong. I admit I was wrong about that. But I did say that Frankie Edgar's going to put up a tough fight. And I said, you know, everybody who's completely overlooking him, you know, this guy's tough. Because everybody overlooked him like Penn was just going to walk all over him. I didn't think that was going to happen, but I did pick Penn to win, so... Anyway, so I was completely blown away by Edgar's performance, you know. It was so close. Each round I was just sitting there going, you know, I don't know which guy won, you know. I was sitting there thinking, you know, it could have went either way. The only round where I was like, okay, he won that round for sure was the last round, and that was what Edgar won, you know. A lot of guys, I think John Anik and I think Franklin McNeil and Michael Dave Smith, all those guys gave it 3-2 for Frankie. So I mean, those guys are some pretty big experts on MMA. I have to agree, I guess. You know, it was such a close fight, and Frankie clearly won the last round. That's probably what stood out to the judges, you know. But it was a tough fight, man, and it was pretty much just a boxing match. You know, Frankie took him to the ground twice, but you know, BJ just sprung right back up. But a huge win for Frankie. Props to Frankie. I like Frankie. He's a really cool dude. You know, BJ's not going anywhere. He'll be right back. He'll probably, you know, face Kenny Florian, somebody like that again. and I'm sure he'll be right back in there, and he'll be fighting for the belt again very soon. So, you BJ Penn fans don't have nothing to worry about. He'll be back for sure. But he looked flat in that fight, man. You know, Frankie looked good, but BJ just looked flat. Like, I don't know what was BJ's problem. I don't think BJ's cardio was as good as it has been in the last two fights. Maybe he overlooked Frankie a little bit, even though he said he hadn't been, but I don't know. Anyway, that was a good fight. But up next was the main event. Okay. And this main event drove Dana White insane, and it drove me insane as well. Alright. I got a lot to cover. Anderson Silva. At times, you wanna praise the guy because he just does stuff where you're just like, that's not possible. Like, how did he just do that? And at other times, he does stuff that makes you want to pull your hair. Like, what is he doing? Because you know what he's capable of. Basically, in this fight, the first two rounds, Silva looked like the guy, you know, that nobody can mess with, that nobody can touch. You know, it was like watching a movie yet again with him. He was, you know, showboating a lot, which I lost a lot of respect for. I don't like showboating. You know, if you're going to showboat, I mean, if you can showboat like that, go ahead and finish the fight. You know, come on. Stop messing with everybody and messing with your opponent. That's completely disrespectful. And he said that Maya was disrespectful before the fight, but I really don't find any of Maya's comments too disrespectful. He was just saying he was going out there to win and stuff. And he never really said nothing terrible about Silva. Anyways, I don't know what Silva's problem is, but he was just completely showboating. And some of the stuff, I mean, it was entertaining because I was just going, what? Why is he doing that? And, like, he would just strike out of crazy positions. And, you know, he switches up stances like crazy. And, I mean, the first two rounds, he showed you why, you know, he's considered the best fighter, you know, ever. And I'm just sitting there like, this guy is amazing. And I'm like, he hadn't finished him yet, but it's coming. And, I mean, yeah, he's kind of shoving a little bit, but it's really entertaining. So I was enjoying it. I was like, this is cool. This is why I gave this fight 2 stars and 3/4, just because of the two rounds, because they were really entertaining. But the last three, Silva, you know, just danced around him. And you know, Maya's nose was broken, everything. And if Silva wanted to end this fight, he could. All it would take was one knee to the nose, and Maya would have crumbled. And all he had to do was just jump on him. Silva can finish this fight if he wanted to, and I don't know why he didn't. It was so bad, man. He was just running around. It was so bad that Dana White went up to the Silva's corner before the fifth round and, you know, was chewing on Silva's manager, like, finish this fight. Come on. You know, these people pay good money to see this, and you're just going to dance around? You know, what are you doing? So, you know, Silva did the same thing in the fifth round, and this is the first time I've ever seen this happen, but Dan Mergliotta stopped the fight and, you know, told Silva, this is the first time I've ever seen this in UFC, he told Silva that he would take a point away if he kept dancing around like that. Like, I've never seen that in UFC before. But it was bad, man. Silva, you just, like, you see stuff like that, you see the first two rounds, and you're like, man, this guy's amazing. I'm ready to crown him the greatest of all time, but, you know, the most dominant person in all sports, because I don't even think Michael Jordan was this dominant in basketball. I mean, that's what I was getting ready to crown him, and then he pulls that, and you're just like, what? I don't know, man. I don't understand Anderson Silva. He won the fight by decision, but, you know, it was terrible, man. It was a terrible main event. It wasn't just like the latest fight, but I even said that in my preview. I said, you know, look at the past, Striker versus Grapplers. The latest fight was terrible. Silva can finish these guys, but he won't. You know, I don't know. It blows my mind. I don't understand. Maybe he got tired. I kind of thought about that. I said maybe he got tired because he did look a lot more muscular than he has been. And, you know, muscles need oxygen, and maybe he got tired. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know what to say. They even said before the fight that he would go to 170 to fight GSP after the fight, but I don't even know if that's going to happen now because, you know, Dana don't want to promote that fight after Silva's coming off this performance, so I don't know, man. This really hurts the UFC, though, because this was, you know, in Abu Dhabi, the first time over there, and it just hurts the UFC, man. But whatever. That's what I thought about the fights, man. Just not too good a night of fights, but I'm ready for Strikeforce, man. But thanks for watching my review, guys, and take care.